Well, after a history of controversies, it looks like the community is finally starting to hold people accountable for enabling Trisha Paytas. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel's all about mental health. What I like to do sometimes is take different topics going on in the YouTube community and try to see what lessons we can learn from them, because some of the most valuable lessons I've ever been able to learn is from other people. So anyways, if you're into that stuff, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. All right, so yeah, there is a lot of backlash right now on Morgan Adams' new video. She did a collab with Trisha Paytas, and Ryland Adams and Shane Dawson were in the video as well. And it was a video where she's like wearing Trisha Paytas' clothes. And I was curious. I was like, what's the community's response to this? Because I believe this video was recorded before Trisha Paytas' most recent controversy, which we will cover. But I was curious what the response was gonna be. And in this video, we're gonna be talking about, you know, our friendships, our mental health, who we're hanging out with, enabling, and all that kind of stuff. And real quick, in case you missed it, the other day I posted up a new video. It's an interview with the best-selling author, Lori Gottlieb. She's an amazing therapist and author. She actually used to be a writer for TV shows like Friends and ER, and then she became a therapist. Anyways, we talk a lot about the therapeutic process, so I'll link that up in the info card. Go check that interview out. It's a little bit longer, so go like clean your house or do whatever and just listen to the interview with her. All right, but yeah, so let's jump into it and talk about Trisha Paytas' most recent controversy. And I highly suggest too that you check out a newer channel called Hello Leash. It's a young woman named Alicia. She is awesome, and she's done a recent series talking about all the controversies Trisha Paytas has been in. Alicia is awesome. She is also a fellow person in long-term recovery. Our sobriety days are actually pretty close too. Anyways, if you haven't checked her channel out, it's blowing up. She's doing awesome. Go check that out. But anyways, most recently, Trisha Paytas was in some hot water for her videos about, you know, having dissociative identity disorder. She made her Meet My Alters video and her Switch Caught on Camera video. She made her video where she screamed at Anthony Padilla. And yeah, it stirred up quite a bit of backlash from the mental health community, because of the way she was, you know, pretty much faking having dissociative identity disorder. And not only did it affect the YouTuber DissociaDID, but a lot of people in the DID community, right? And since then, you know, things haven't gotten much better. Like Trisha Paytas, almost on a daily basis, has been, you know, arguing with Ethan Klein from H3H3 Productions because she's been sleeping with his brother-in-law. And, you know, Trisha Paytas is very vocal about, you know, her promiscuity and everything like that. And yeah, but, you know, I wanted to see how the community was reacting to this new collab Morgan Adams did with Trisha Paytas. And first, like, let's take a look at Morgan Adams' recent videos and the like to dislike ratio. So on February 3rd, she did her, you know, trying dumb TikTok life hacks video, and it only had 2,600 dislikes. After that, she did her video talking about overcoming her depression, which I loved. I actually did a video breaking that down, and 1,800 dislikes. Then Confessing Everything I Lied About, that's her last video before this one, 1,400 dislikes. And now this one with Trisha Paytas, I noticed right away, almost 10,000 dislikes. And I was like, huh, what are people saying about this? So I just want to read a few of the top comments real quick. I really can't wrap my head around the fact that Morgan and Shane talk so much about mental health but still hang out with Trish. Also, Trish has disrespected the LGBTQ community before, with Shane and Ryland are a part of, but still manage to somehow hang out with her. Don't get me wrong, I love Shane, Ryland, and Morgan, but I really don't understand this situation. The next one says, the fact that people still stand Trish is absurd. Even if she is an actual good person behind cameras, doing content that is offensive to so many people for more clout is disgusting. You don't have to be a trash human to be famous. And the next one, the fact that they're still willing to hang out with Trish after all her actions speaks about their character as well. Trish mocked the LGBTQ plus people. Shane and Ryland fall into that community. She mocks mental health issues. Shane and Morgan admittedly suffer from some. and they don't find her actions appalling, they still feel like she's a good person to hang around and include in their lives. Obviously, whatever intervention or talk they may have in the background does not work because she does the same things just with other groups. All right, and these comments go on and on and on and on and on. All right, so let's talk about enabling real quick. This is something that we've talked about before, and this is something that is so important to me as a recovering drug addict and alcoholic, working with a bunch of drug addicts and alcoholics when I was working at a rehab. Most of us, not even when it comes to addiction, most of us cannot continue what we're doing if it wasn't for other people enabling us, right? Obviously that is very apparent when it comes to, you know, substance abuse, but what about behaviors, right? What about people who are doing things like, you know, Trisha Paytas is doing now? Most of us in our own lives, we don't have a Trisha Paytas who has millions of followers and, you know, making videos and stuff like this. But like, think about the people in your life who have these, like, these behaviors that they're doing. Maybe, you know, they're constantly fighting with people. Maybe they're, you know, constantly just like stirring up trouble, right? Like, maybe every time you go out with them to, you know, the bar or whatever, they're stirring stuff up, you know, whatever it is, whatever these behaviors are. By continuing to hang out with them, we are enabling that behavior, because what we are saying is, this is okay. This is okay, you can do this and there are no consequences to this. Now, it's easy to have this little cop out and say, oh, well, they're their own person, I can't control what they do, right? No, that's very true. That is very true. We cannot control what the people in our lives do, but we can control whether or not we hang out with them and encourage them, right? Like, human beings are wired for rewards, okay? Like, when we do something and we're rewarded for it, our brain says that's okay to do it again, right? And something that you'll notice with many people, and I think Trisha Paytas and other YouTubers are very good examples, is there are zero consequences. Zero consequences, right? Something that a lot of people talk about, especially when it comes to Trisha Paytas, is that she goes through these cycles, right? Her views start to drop, and then she finds some controversy to get herself in. Views spike, she's in, you know, everybody's talking about her again and everything like that, you know? And it just keeps happening over and over and over again. And worst case scenario, they lose some subscribers. Literally doesn't matter. They're still making millions and millions of dollars. And then the collaborations with her, that is promoting her to even more people, but it's also co-signing her, right? It's, that's something that bothers me a little bit more, because when you look at, you know, all the different audiences, right? You have Morgan's audience, and I know a lot of these are combined, but you have Morgan's audience, Ryland's audience, Shane Dawson's audience. When they're all hanging out with Trisha Paytas, the message that that is sending to the viewers is, hey, we're okay with what she does, so you should be too, right? And that's a scary thing, because they have so much influence. So I'm glad to see that people are actually vocalizing, like, hey, we are not okay with this, you know? So the last thing that I want to talk about is this. So another thing that's easy to do is to be like, hey, you know, I'm not just going to hang out with somebody because other people don't like them. And like, that's very true. Do your thing, baby boo. Do your thing, right? But we have to recognize when we're lying to ourselves, right? Like, people aren't just saying, don't hang out with her because we don't like her for some random reason. They're saying it because of behaviors that are hurting many other people, okay? So I just think this is something that we all need to start thinking about, especially when it comes to keeping the people in our lives. Like, I cannot stress to you enough, my mental health got so much better when I started auditing who I was keeping in my life, right? Like, when I got sober almost 8 years ago, so many people didn't make the cut. So many people had to go, right? And my brain's like, oh, but they're my friend, I've known them for years, da 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 da. The reality was, like, if I wanted to keep my head on straight, I had to cut certain people out. I only surround myself with people who are on this level of like, oh, I really respect and like what they're doing. Like, these are good people, right? They motivate me to do better. Those are the type of people I surround myself with today. And I think that's something that we all need to think about. All right. Anyways, that's all I got for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And a huge, huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon, as well as everybody who supports the channel by buying my mental health books at therewiredsoul.com, as well as the merch from the merch store. You're all awesome. All right. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you next time.